So, but another thing we wanted to talk about today is we touched on it like last episode, but I wanted to go deeper and like talk about like, you know, the black experience and just like what it means to, if the black experience includes like letting stuff go.
Meaning, that's a tough one.
Meaning like, all right, so you got a sports team that you support, but you know the history of like, you know, they didn't allow black players to play until like, you know, 100 years after they existed. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But then
how about this? I got a perfect example. Over the past week we heard about Prince Harry, Prince William. Getting engaged to I don't even know her name, but the actress who
Meghan Markle.
She's biracial. She's a biracial actress.
Yeah.
Whereas the royal family has had a very, very long history of racism, discriminatory practices towards people of color and other different people, and oh my goodness, what is going on right now?
Continue.
You know what I mean? A lot of discriminatory practices and whatnot. And here in 2017, there's someone of color that's actually gonna make it into, you know what I mean, to the royal family. So how do you deal with that? How do you feel with like someone who's wronged you for so long? You know what I mean? And you finally get a chance to become a part of their ranks.
Well. I look at it this way. If we get a foot in the door, is a foot in the door.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? On one hand, we shouldn't be groveling at these crackers' feet and try to get their acceptance all the fucking time or at all. We shouldn't be trying to get their acceptance at all. But if they come and they try, you know, sorry, if they come in, you know,
and include us,
that's a foot in the door. So now she's gonna. Dilute is a terrible word to use because that has a negative connotation. She is gonna
infiltrate.
I wanted to say infiltrate. She's infiltrating that bloodline. You know what I'm saying? And everybody's screaming, "Oh, she's half black and she doesn't identify as black. She identifies as biracial." And you're not gonna sit here and tell me she's not a black woman because she is a black woman. You know what I'm saying? And we spoke about it the other podcast about colorism with Cardi B and all that. Mm-hmm. And that is a big thing going on right now, colorism. People say, oh, she's not black or she's not black enough. It's like, no, she's black. That's all that fucking matters. Mm-hmm. And now she's in the royal family. And now, you know, we have chess pieces at several places ready to move and take over.
Yeah, the royal family. Hey.
You know what I'm saying? That's real shit.
True.
Because
true.
I don't care how big of a glass of water you have or whatever. You drop a little piece of black in it, it's going to mix and change, right?
It'll be gray. Gray water.
We infiltrate, bro.
I feel you.
Like, come on, man. But, sorry, not to ramble. That doesn't mean Prince Harry is black either.
Nah.
He's still a cracker. Because I see shit on Twitter like, oh, he's married a black girl. Somebody said, oh, he can say the N-word now. No, the fuck he can't. Who the fuck said Prince Harry can say nigga? He can't say yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to hear that shit.
Nigger in the British accent?
I can't.
I'm pretty sure you can.
Nigga.
No, I can't.
Nigga.
I can't.
They're probably the first to say it.
They might have been the first to say it. Hey, well, one thing I will say, though, the royal family in about like 15, 20 years is going to be lit as fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. We go here. Go out niggas with dreads in the royal family.
Oh, you.
Their party's going to be lit.
You know her mom has dreads.
Her mom got dressed?
Yeah, her mom is a black woman with dreads.
See? Prophetic.
Already.
Yeah.
I'm prophetic of this bitch.
I know that.
What our audience members said they're gonna be chiefing in the royal family soon, if they're not already.
Word.
Oh, I'm pretty sure they are.
They probably get a fire instead of fire.
Queen Elizabeth be blowing.
Word. There's a reason she's living so long.
Oh, you took the words right out of my mouth. Word. Shit is extending her
ain't
life.
No stress on her mind.
Back to the main topic. You said in the back experience is one part of it. You said, did you say forgetting or forgiving? Or
letting things
go.
Yeah.
Now,
Go ahead. Because it's like this. It's like if you look into the history of anything, you're going to see that at one point you weren't a part of it, which is hard for like, you know what I'm saying? And it's literally with everything you do. Like if you pick up a video game and say you want to play this video game, you got to decide whether you're just going to live with the fact that there are zero black characters in that video game. You know what I'm saying? Or, you know, it, and just enjoy the video game for what it is. You know what I'm saying? That there are certain things, like, you got to, as a black person, to enjoy certain things, you have to let certain things go. But then where do you draw that line? Like, that's my question. It's like, where do you draw the line? It's like, all right, I'm gonna let this slide just for the sake of my sanity. But to be somebody who can consider themselves woke and fighting for equality, like, there's some shit you can't let slide.
And you took the words right out of my mouth. You're right. It's some shit, regardless of what happens, you cannot let it slide.
Mm-hmm.
One of those things is preserving our history.
Yeah.
I'm going to use this example. I'm going to go out there. I heard one person say that because it says it in the Bible that Jesus doesn't look how they're portraying him.
Mm.
The image of Jesus you see, the long flowing hair and the white skin and the little goatee, is the image of Caesar Borgia. And it's not a myth. It's not a conspiracy theory or anything. It's true.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it started there, them trying to wash away our history.
Mm.
Now, people say Jesus wasn't black.
Can this white
but he wasn't
savior.
White. Mm. You know what I'm saying? I would consider Jesus black. And I heard someone say that, oh, it doesn't matter. No, it does matter. See, that's what they tell you.
Mm.
That's it doesn't matter. No, it does matter. Let's say Jesus is black. That is one of the biggest winning pieces we need on our side. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Don't just brush that under the rug.
The thing is, it doesn't matter because it's a representation of you. So it doesn't matter to you. So it's like, but it's like, it's one thing when they bitch about, like, superheroes being being the color that they started off as in the 1940s.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
yeah. They're fictional characters.
They're fictional characters. Spider-Man can't be black. You know what I'm saying? When somebody thought about him in the 1940s, he
Santa
made him
Claus
white.
Can't
of course.
Be black.
How about fuck Spider-Man, fuck Santa Claus, fuck all those comic book heroes? What about these Egyptian movies?
But that's what I'm getting to. You know what I'm saying? So
that was facts.
They trip over. You know what I'm saying? You could have that.
Yeah.
As my concern.
Take it.
Fictional character, whatever. But when you start to fuck with history. You know what I'm saying? I try to whitewash history and try
shit
to
that happened.
And trying to turn around and say it doesn't matter. I'm like, if it doesn't matter, why did you create it to your image then?
Boom.
You know
thank you.
You know what I'm saying? If it didn't matter, why did Napoleon shoot the noses off the sphinxes in
Egypt?
Yeah,
because they had nigga noses.
Yeah.
They had big nostrils.
Imagine those huge statues. Imagine the effort. I'm
such
on a bullets,
yo.
Because they shot him off.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine how long that took.
Yeah. That's a deep-seated and deep-rooted
That's a considerable, like, effort.
Yeah.
And
to say the least.
Let's destroy this shit that's been here for hundreds of years. Just to further our
agenda.
Yeah.
Knock on wood. I don't drink soda, though.
Where?
Not even just looking at it.
But yeah, like, as far as letting things go, like, maybe in a way I'll let it go is where I won't complain about it as much, but I can't unknow it.
Mm.
I'm going to still think about it. I'm going to still talk about it, but I'm not going to be here. If you talk about that, then maybe.
Yeah.
it's still maybe. Because you're not just going, like, Michael Che, he's a Saturday Night Live member. He's a stand-up comedian. He made a good point about Black Lives Matter and All Lives Matter, the counter protests and everything. And he made a point. He said, "You know what? I'm gonna wear a shirt on 9/11 that says All Buildings Matter." And that shit was fucking genius.
Yeah.
I was like, maybe not these crackers understand it.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And then on top of that, people say never forget 9/11, never forget the Holocaust, never forget Vietnam, never forget the both world wars, so on and so forth. But they brushed slavery under the rug, which was the absolute worst thing, whether it was with Jewish people, whether it was with Egyptians, whoever was enslaved. Slavery
Libyans.
Is the worst thing to ever happen to humans, to force humans to work without...
But more specifically, like, American slavery.
Yes.
Because never, well, let me not say never, because I don't know that for sure. But American slavery is far more cruel, far more dehumanizing than most of you know, like other instances of slavery within history. Because they always bring up the argument, Africans had enslaved each other, or
slavery. Oh, Africans sold slaves.
Yeah, or slavery existed in the Middle East before you know, Americans took it up, or before white people, or, you know, Europe or whatever.
Uh-huh.
But it did, but it was never to the degree, and it never looked the same.
Yeah.
Like it wasn't carried out, because it's one thing to say someone is a slave, it's one thing to dehumanize them.
Yeah.
And they dehumanize black people.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, the whole reason why we specify races is to put black people on the bottom rung.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's why it's a, oh, he's the first black actor.
Cause yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like, well,
yeah, because before that, like, people acknowledged that some people had lighter skin and some people had darker skin.
There wasn't a classification.
There was never a classification. It was never this person belonged to another race.
Yes.
Race and how we talk about it doesn't exist.
Yeah, it's a social construct. It's something that we created. It was literally created to put a certain type of human in a higher class than another human, so they could justify selling someone into slavery.
Word. So, but now
don't forget the 3/5 compromise.
But then now,
the 3/5 compromise is shaky, because it's a little. It's good and bad in certain aspects.
The
very base of it all is saying that, yeah, black people are worth 3/5 of a human, but...
And not a whole.
you're absolutely right, but the alternative was black people not having any representation at all Southern states.
That's true.
So it is kind of, yeah, 3/5 of a... What the fuck is that?
There's always a but.
Yeah.
Slavery's over, but you're 3/5 of human. All right, we're not doing a 3/5 compromise, but you're going to go to prison, which is modern-day slavery. Mm-hmm. There's always a but.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? There's always something hidden behind. Like, growing up, I thought Abraham Lincoln was the greatest president ever.
Yeah.
Oh, he freed the slaves. No, he freed the slaves because it benefited him and America in some way. But I don't know the specifics, even though I should.
Yeah,
but he didn't free him on some... This is a bad thing. Let's stop this. It wasn't on that.
Yeah,
but I grew up thinking that.
People always say, "Oh man, this was a long time ago." Da-da. People still in America still, black people have been slaves longer than they have been free.
Yeah.
Still.
Yeah. Yeah.
Still. So it's like, keep that in mind. In America, black people have been slaves longer than they've been free. So thinking about that. Understand.
That's crazy.
Understand. That means generations, bro. Generations.
Yeah.
So that means now, even when we got free, that's a generation of black people who don't know how to be free.
Oh, say it again.
And then the next generation, that's a generation.
Not a function. Yeah.
That's a generation of black people who are newly free in a white supremacist society.
Exactly.
So they don't even know how to function within that society.
They don't know how to be free and black.
Exactly.
They know how to be free.
Exactly.
And
you jump out of a pool full of barracudas.
Word.
You jump to a pool full of sharks.
And then,
or vice versa. You can use it any way you want.
And then there's a generation who's kind of like, okay, we want a little bit more for ourselves. Da 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 da. And then that generation got fucked up.
Are you talking about Black Wall Street?
Yeah, and I'm talking about Black Wall Street. I'm talking about the war on drugs. I'm talking about AIDS. I'm talking about the crack epidemic.
Well, no, crack is included on the war on drugs.
Yeah. I'm talking about all of that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It was always something. It was always something.
Word. So it's like, because even now you talk about, 80s babies and like the crack era
crack
stuff.
Babies.
Like, there have been times where it's like, okay, we've made progress, and then they've fought. So it's like generations. So it's generations of us being slaves. Then it's generations of like Jim Crow and just like, you know what I'm saying? So it's like we're just getting to a point where things
COINTELPRO, all that good shit.
Yeah. So we're just, so this whole America where they want everything to look equal, that's new.
Yeah. And then,
so us aesthetically looking equal is new.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. That's very true. I hate to quote this creep, but facts are facts. Louis C.K., he was on Conan, and he said, he was talking about slavery because he keeps it real, even though he's a creep. He said, everybody said, oh, slavery was 500 years ago. He said, slavery was 140 years ago. That's 2 7-year-old ladies dying back to back. Think about that. Yeah. They always throw that 300. Every year it grows 100 years. They're probably telling these little kids in school slavery was 600 years ago.
Nah.
No, it was closer than you're comfortable with.
Yeah.
Niggas.
It was more recent than any functioning human can be comfortable with.
Dog, niggas was coming back from fighting World War II just to be lynched at the crib.
Imagine that. I fought for your country and you gonna kill me?
You survived a war. Come home, get worse done to you at home than overseas, bro.
If they don't kill you, you're going to eventually die because how they treat you.
Yeah, though.
For the people, for the same people you just fought for. But getting back to the original question, I know, I mean, we've touched on a lot of different subjects, but to answer the original question, how do you let go? I don't know. For me personally, it seems like the more you learn, the harder it becomes to kind of let go.
Facts.
I mean, because once you start digging into all these atrocities and the impacts they really have, and you look at where we are today and how we actually got to where we are today, they played a huge role in that. I mean, that's just saying it lightly, you know what I mean? So, I mean, you kind of got to be in a place where you see what happened. And you recognize what happened. You recognize, like, the parties and the roles they played and, you know what I mean, how everything ties together. But then you got to kind of make a decision for yourself whether you're gonna be a part of the same narrative, and decide what role you're going to have in changing that.
True.
You know what I mean? So, like, it might be different for – you might be an educator. You might be the revolutionary on the ground. You might be the person – building up the businesses to uplift the community. You might be
buy back the block.
You know what I mean? You might buy back the block. You could be the black artist depicting what's actually going on in our neighborhoods. You know what I mean? But like I think it's important to carry on forward, knowing, being cognizant of the history. But instead of putting your energy and your focus on, I don't know, putting your energy and focus into moving forward as opposed to reliving the past.
Exactly. Like, let's say you bring up a situation, you complain about it. The same energy you got complaining about it, try to fix it.
Exactly.
Don't just sit there and complain about, they won't give us loans. Or do something.
So, for example.
About it. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever.
So, for example, stuff like Juneteenth and things like that. And, like, I feel like, you know, because it's black, you know, it's kind of like, all right, so after that, it's kind of like put to the back burner. But I feel like certain things we need to, like I said in the last episode, certain things we need to celebrate and make sure traditions don't die. And then certain other things, like, because there's so many battles.
Like, oh, yeah, it's never ending.
Like, a random example, clowns.
Oh, I learned the dark history behind that recently.
So if you ever wonder why clowns have afros and big noses, they're making fun of black people. So
2 + 2 = 4.
So as a black person, do you automatically just hate all clowns? You know what I'm saying? It's just those little things too. So because it's so much.
Yeah, they got big feet.
And they have big feet.
Yeah,
it's so much. It's like if you don't pick your battles, you're gonna go crazy.
Yeah, like you can't be mad about everything. It's literally impossible. You will kill yourself from aneurysm.
You know what I'm saying? You can be educated on everything. You watch a show. There's a token black person. And they make the token black person jokes.
Like, and they talk slang.
Do you let that slide?
It is what it is. Leave that there. And you know what I think is making it easier to do that too? The fact that, I mean, in media today, we're getting more and more accurate and genuine representation. You know what I mean?
Like Black-ish.
There's shows like Black-ish. There's Issa show on HBO. There's
Insecure.
There's that Nola Darling. There's more and more stuff that's coming out for us. by us. So
FUBU.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Hey, hey, I heard they're revamping FUBU or something.
Oh, I hope they do. I'm gonna be first in line. You know what I mean?
So when you see that show created by white people,
first of all,
curated by white people with that one token black person, okay. Mm. I see it, but that's not real. I'm going to turn over here, yeah. And I'm going to pay attention to what I know, word. What I can actually something relate that to.
Something that relates to me, word. Exactly.
I'm low-key mad at black people for letting FUBU fall off.
Yeah, well, no. You can't be mad at black people.
Other things
because
came, yo.
If you want to be absolutely technical, black people still wear FUBU. Mm. I saw FUBU yesterday, I believe. Mm. You know what I'm saying? You can't blame that on black people.
Did the person you see wearing the FUBU have a home? Is that that's a
did,
real
were
question.
They did they buy it in the two in the early 2000s?
They were wearing it. It doesn't matter.
But it's like stuff like that, man. We need to renew, and I see it more.
Yeah,
which is hard. And I see people more conscious of supporting black business and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? It's like so. There's light at the end of the tunnel, but it's just like the history is so fucked up.
Yeah, like that's what people don't understand. They tell you to be strong, they tell you to fight. Like I am fighting, I am being strong. But every day I find out something terrible about my people. Mm-hmm. History about my people. Like I just found out that clown shit, I want to say a month ago.
Mm-hmm.
I've been alive for 29 years on this earth and I didn't know that about clowns until like a month ago.
Damn, that's mm-hmm. it.
You know what I'm saying? And don't even let me get into the tangent of what they teach us and not teach us in school.
Yeah.
I learned about Nat Turner in 12th grade outside of the curriculum.
Yeah.
Because you remember when they added 7th and 8th period? My 8th period class was, shout out Mr. King, our 8th period class was African American Studies.
Okay. Mm.
And I'm so glad I took that class. Yeah. I found out so much shit.
Man.
I found out about Nat Turner. I looked at every cracker cross-eyed after that, bro. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, jump if you want to.
And you know what's crazy? That is an elective. They're not going to teach everybody that.
An elective, some you choose. Like, do I want to take this class?
I went to Pines Charter, right?
Okay.
Which is predominantly, I would say, Hispanic.
Like every school in Florida.
Yeah.
It's predominantly black.
Hispanic, you know, couple of W's. And they, you know, they have a good pocket of black people. But, you know, if you go into the African Studies class, it's not but black kids.
Yeah.
The kids who really need to be in that class, learning why their parents is fucking up, aren't in that class. And they don't learn nothing. It's like, I feel like people feel like black history is just for black people. And that's a big issue into why a lot of W's really don't see where we're coming from when we say this shit. So we'll say this shit and W's be like, what are you talking about? This happened millions of years ago. Because they're not educated in it.
I hate to bring it up, but the Holocaust happened a long time ago. Would I ever in my life go to a Jewish person? I don't want to call him a Jew.
Mm.
Because
you just did.
Jew is the only term for a set of people that's the slur and the proper thing to call them. And that's the second time I quoted Louis C.K. But I would never go to
it's
a
just
Jewish...
just depends on their cadence.
Yeah. I would never go to a Jewish person and say, forget about the Holocaust. Are you crazy?
Yeah.
Why is it okay for you to say that to black people about slavery? Why is it fine?
Yeah.
I will never forget about slavery. It's some shit you learn and you never fucking forget. And that's of many.
But then you can't, because you know what Americans fail to admit is that slavery is the reason why their country is the way it is now.
That's another thing.
The whole reason your country is so wealthy is because niggas built it for free.
Off their backs.
Off their fucking backs,
for
nigga.
For the free.
For the free. The White House was built by niggas.
The White House.
For White House. For free. So it's like...
I'll throw an egg at that
so
shit.
So it's like...
Let me stop.
So it's like, how in the fuck we responsible... For your whole economy being weird, and it's nothing else. It's literally nothing else, bro. Cause like if you look at it now, if you look at why America is a superpower, they're only number one in one thing, and that's the military.
Fighting.
And that's why they go extra hard for the military, cause they know if the military lose funding, they're no longer a superpower. Cause that's the only weight they hold. They have the strongest military. That's the only thing America has to say over a country like China, over a country like England. You know what I'm saying? Like to say that, oh, we we have some kind of say into what goes around in the world and shit. Cause yeah. it's definitely not our dollar.
We the bully.
It's
we always bring the biggest gun to the conversation.
Word.
But that's the only reason people listen.
It makes sense because when you figure out, when you realize how the country is founded, it's really on some bully shit.
Real talk. But all in all, in my opinion, you shouldn't let go.
Mm.
But at the same time, exactly.
That's
don't let it bear down on you or stress you out. You cannot let something go and it can still be healthy. You know what I'm saying? If any cracker ever tell you to let slavery go, say fuck you or punch him in the face, one of the two. And you know, keep it moving. You have to know about your history. They know about why we can't know about our history. They know everything about their history.
Mm-hmm.
Why is it so taboo to say?
Them niggas, you know, got family crests. And can family trace their family back hundreds of years. While we was chained up next to niggas that didn't even speak the same language.
For real.
So it's like, yo, you can know your history, we can't know ours. Off rip.
And as Morgan Freeman said, black history is American history.
It is.
Oh, Ben.
Like,
Ben.
And I would encourage any W's who happen to us. First of all, shout out to all the W's that listen to us, because we beat up on y'all a lot.
Yeah, we do.
So if you out there and you white and you still listen to us, shout out to you, because you that means you sifted through a lot of foolishness. You know what I'm saying? You let it brush over your shoulder because you didn't take it personal, because you know we weren't talking about you specifically.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? When we talk about crack ass crackers, we talk about crack ass crackers.
Yeah.
And you and W's know who we're talking about.
Exactly.
Because I've heard W's talk about, you know, hey, they some crack ass crackers. You know what I'm saying? So they know what we talking about.
Yeah, them crackers with sister mothers.
Yeah.
You're right. Now if you white and brother cousins. If you a W and you still listening to us, honestly, from the bottom of my heart, I can say
yeah, that means you home.
You my nigga, honestly.
Yeah. Word.
And your invitation to the barbecue is still pending. Mm-hmm. You can't just invite everyone.
We not going to decline you though. It's pending.
I mean, come through the bar. If you at this
it's pending. To this nigga.
At this, no, as much as we beat up on W's, the fact that we call them W's, I'm
disrespectful.
It is. I'm guaranteed there's some white people who have heard us say W and didn't realize we were talking about them.
Yeah, now you know.
Till weeks after, you know what I'm saying? Nope. And y'all still rocking with us. So shout out to y'all. You know.
Don't worry, we're going to make a TPSG dictionary.
Yeah.
One day.